So Jagannatha Das Babaji, he is called as Vaishnav Sarvabhaum. That's him, Jagannatha Das Babaji. Like Sakshat Vairagya Murti, called Krishna Das Babaji. And then Vaishnav Sarvabhaum Jagannatha Das Babaji. He was a person who played a key role in preserving our Gaudiya Vaishnav Sampradaya's philosophy. Because by his time, philosophy was lost. Actually, in Gaudiya Vaishnavism, there were three dark periods in the history of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. So, one dark period came after Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associates left. That was one dark period where people forgot philosophy. There were so many upper sampradayas. People were confused. So, after that dark period, three people came to revive it. And we all know, Narottam, Srinivacharya and Shyamanand Pandit. And these three were actually incarnations of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu and Advaita Acharya. You don't know this? So Srinivasa Acharya was one by 12th portion of Lord Chaitanya. I don't know how it's 1 by 12th, but it's 1 by 12th. That's written in Bhakti Ratnakar. So there are some letters from Jiva Goswami to Srinivasa Acharya, and from Srinivasa Acharya to Jiva Goswami. We have those letters. And in those letters, Jiva Goswami writes to Srinivasa Acharya that Srinivasa Acharya is a disciple of, by the way, Jiva Goswami, Shiksha disciple. So Jiva Goswami is writing Srinivasa Acharya that that anyway you don't need to respect me, because we all know that you are carrying one twelfth potential of Lord Chaitanya. So he's giving respect. So that we know. And Shyamanand Pandit, Narottam Das Thakur, he is incarnation of Nityananda Prabhu, that potency. And Shyamanand Pandit is having potency of Advaita Acharya. So this Narottam Das Thakur, Nityananda Prabhu. So all these three people came again to revive, because that dark period. So this is first dark period between Chaitanya Prabhu associates and then Narottam Das Thakur, Shyamanand Pandit, and so that they revived. But then again another dark period came where everything went down. And in this period, then afterwards everything went down. Then again some great acharyas came, Vishwachakri Thakur, Valdevidyabhushan and Jagannatha Das Babaji. So they actually Vishwachakri Thakur and Valdevidyabhushan, they were there. They revived again. They revived. So this was second dark period. But then after them again there was a dark period. And then actually Chaitanya Prabhu's philosophy is very complex and very deep. So it is a boon and it is a curse also, because if things are very deep, then very quickly they become lost, people become confused. So then again dark period came, and then to revive again Bhaktivedanta Thakur, Bhakti Siddhanta and Jagannatha Das Babaji. These three people were there who revived again. So Jagannatha Das Babaji, who was he? Baldevidyabhushan. You know Baldevidyabhushan is initiated by whom? You know? No? You don't know? Come on. How is it you don't know basic things? Like, I'm surprised. Baldevidyabhushan. Baldevidyabhushan is initiated by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur. So his disciple was Uddhav Das Babaji. Yeah, it is not there in, when you read the parampara, it's not there. Because in our parampara, main acharyas are given. So, Uddhav Das Babaji. And Uddhav Das Babaji's disciple was, Uddhav Das Babaji's disciple was Madhusudan Das Babaji. who is actually famous, Madhusudan Das Babaji. In Vrindavan, if you go to Suryakund, you know Suryakund, there is a place Suryakund near Radhakund, where Srimati Radharani goes in morning, Suryakund, to do worship of Surya. With the plea of doing worship to Surya, but actually she is worshipping the real sun, Krishna. The Suryakund, there he was living, Madhusudan Das Babaji. And he was very famous for his philosophy, his bhajan, very like Pakka Babaji. So this Madhusudan Das Babaji's disciple was Jagannatha Das Babaji. So that is his parampara. Baldevide Bhushan, Uddhav Das, Madhusudan Das, and Jagannatha Das Babaji. So he took a lot of shiksha from him. That is why he was connected to Madhusudan Das Babaji. But actually, his you can get connected to him. Yeah, that's okay. So he was a person. If any philosophical problem was there in Vrindavan or Mayapur, he was a person. People used to approach him. In fact, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to approach him to ask philosophical conclusions and problems. Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to associate with him. Jagannatha Das Babaji used to respect Bhaktivinoda Thakur a lot. Because once Bhaktivinoda Thakur's family, they came, Bhaktivinoda Thakur's wife and the children. So they thought, okay, let's go and have blessings of Jagannatha Das Babaji. So this Bhaktivinoda Thakur was staying in Godroom, and Jagannatha Das Babaji was staying in Navdeep, the present Navdeep. You have gone to Mayapur, Navdeep? Gone. So Mayapur is on that side of Ganges, no? Mm-hmm. Navdeep is this side, no? Mm-hmm. Where railway station is there. So near Ghat, that Ghat is there, from where we cross to Mayapur. You know that, no?
Yeah.
That ghat. Remember, ghat is there. Ghat, ghat. It is called Hular Ghat. Hular Ghat. So in that, from there, if you walk 20 minutes on same Navdeep island, then there is house of Jagannatha Das Babaji. You have gone there? House. Not gone there. So there is, he used to live there. Still it is there. His samadhi is there.
His samadhi is
where?
On the road.
You've gone there?
We saw samadhis, but
of that, you know. Why is it?
When we went, you know, we didn't go with that mood. You know, our mood is different. So,
It is very inside. It is not on the main road.
Oh.
You have to go very inside, and then there is a house. So that is there, and so Jagannatha Das Babaji. So once Bhaktivinoda Thakur's wife and children, they came to him to take blessings. So Jagannatha Babaji said, you go back. He said, in your house a pure devotee is living, a Paramahamsa is living, a Manjari is living in your house, and you're coming to me. He said, they're lost. He said, if you come to me, then he will go away. That is what was like respect of Jagannatha Das Babaji for Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So actually these people knew, you know, what are their sarupa. They knew. They like in spiritual world. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to respect Jagannatha Das Babaji a lot. When Jagannatha Das Babaji used to come to his house, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to respect him almost like God. And Jagannatha Das Babaji later then used to appreciate to his disciples that this is how you should receive a Vaishnava. You should learn from him, from Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So
when Jagannatha Das Babaji mentions that, you know, a Manjari is living in your house, was that
Bhakti Siddhanta Sansita? No. He's saying for Bhaktivinoda Thakur. He's your husband, you know.
He's talking about,
oh.
Who is not directly saying to the Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
No, he's telling to his family. Oh. To his wife. See, you're coming here and you're leaving your husband, Bhaktivinoda Thakur. And he's a Manjari. He's living in a house. You You take his blessings, that's all. Or do you want to come to me? You understand?
Yeah, but how he accepted as a disciple of Bhaktivedanta? If he
think
that he's a
Manjari? So what? Bhaktivedanta used to come and ask him philosophical questions and all those. In spiritual world also they are disciples, no? Srinivas Acharya's famous disciple is Ramchandra Kaviraj. And Srinivas Acharya is Manjari and they are both Manjaris. In spiritual world also they are like guru and disciple relationship. Even in spiritual world.
A lot of gopis are assisting.
Yeah, gopis are assisting by Manjari, Manjari are assisting by different Manjaris. So their relationship is different, no? Like they, it's eternal. Something happening, eternal thing. Our dynamics is something else. Their dynamics is totally something else. So he said, and that was the role of Jagannatha Das Babaji. He was the only person at that time in Gaudiya Vaishnava Samaj who knew philosophy. Nobody else knew philosophy. Nobody even knew what is Chaitanya Charitamrita. Chaitanya Charitamrita was lost. Only few people could understand then, but otherwise people were singing songs about Lord Chaitanya, which were famous in Bengal, written by Mahaprabhu's associate, Vasudev Ghosh, Govind Ghosh, Anantacharya, so many songs. And basically philosophical conclusions were lost or they were mixed with Apasampradaya conclusions. Nobody understood anything. Jagannatha Das Babaji knew. So Jagannatha Das Babaji, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he once visited Jagannatha Das Babaji in Vrindavan to actually ask him many instructions. And because Bhaktivinoda Thakur was a writer, he used to write books and he wanted a proper philosophical conclusion, he wanted confirmation. Although he was himself a liberated soul, he could write it, but nevertheless, he went to Jagannatha Das Babaji to get confirmation. That's how liberated souls they act, you know, like, okay, I know I'm a liberated soul and I can write. It doesn't happen like that. So he went. In fact, Bhaktivinoda Thakur used to, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur made yoga peet, you know yoga peet. So they are also, you know that, no? Then when he found that place, when he saw from Godram Deep that a light is there on that place, so he went there and then there was, he was not sure actually this. He was sure he saw light, but he wanted to make sure this is a place of Mahaprabhu's birth. So he called Jagannatha Das Babaji. And when he came to that place, he jumped like 6 feet high. He was 120 years old at that time. 120. So his servant used to carry him in basket. In basket he used to carry on the head one of his servant. He couldn't walk, he couldn't even lift his eyelid. Somebody used to come and want to talk to him, he with hands used to do like that. See, and okay. He was so old. But then when he reached to that place, Mahaprabhu, he jumped 6 feet high and dancing there. Jagannatha Thakur understood, yeah. And then he said, this is my Nimai's birthplace.
So,
he said, this is Nimai's birthplace. So he of course he was a Paramahamsa. He used to take instructions from Madhusudan Das Babaji at Suryakund. So they both used to live in Suryakund. Jagannatha Babaji used to live 6 months in Vrindavan, 6 months in Navadvip. Like that he used to go. So once Jagannatha Babaji, he was coming with his disciples, or his disciple was carrying him on in his basket from Vrindavan to Mayapur. So one lion came in between. Just there. Was standing there and this person with Jagannatha Babaji on the basket. He was sweating, you know, what's happening. And so what happened was, this Jagannatha Babaji told. He was standing and shivering. Jagannatha Babaji, he couldn't see anything. So he told what happened. So he couldn't speak anything. So Jagannatha Babaji, he was his eyes is closed, but so he says, I know there's a lion, but he has come to take my darshan. So don't worry, chant Hare Krishna, he'll go away. So he saw and land went away. That is Jagannatha Das Babaji. So Jagannatha Das Babaji, he used to, these things might not be here because it's there in Saraswati, Jayashree and other books. So he, many times he used to, actually one thing very unique of him and also his instruction was, you should chant loudly. He used to chant loudly. He used to chant in loud voice, Hare Krishna. He never used to chant in his mind, and he said, he instructed his disciples, you should chant loudly. And he sometimes used to go in a marathon of chanting. That's what he was. So, of course, he used to chant 3 lakh names every day. That was, he used to chant. But many times he used to go to, he went to Haridwar. Once he went to Haridwar and he said, okay, make a kutia for me. They made. And then he said, okay, 1 month I'll stay inside that. I'll not come outside. I've taken a vow. And you bring me food at this time, but just put a plate and go away, he told his servant. And don't talk to me. So 1 month he was in that hut, simply chanting day and night. Day and night, day and night, day and night. That's how these people used to be. They're Babaji's, no? They are not. They have to show the absorption in holy name by their actions. But unfortunately, many of his disciples, of course, first of all, he didn't have many disciples, few of them. But many of his disciples were, whatever he had, they couldn't understand about him, even though they were staying with him. And this is a point, you might stay with Paramahamsa, but you may not be able to take any benefit from him. It can happen like that.
Is Babaji means Paramahamsa?
Babaji means Babaji. In Gaudiya Vaishnavism, there are two kind of people. One is Babaji and one is Ghoshtanandi. Ghoshtanandi and Babaji in Gaudiya Vaishnavism. Babajis are those people who do not preach, who simply chant. And Ghoshtanandis are who preach, who don't chant whole day. So Gaurav Babaji, Jagannatha Das Babaji, Vamsiya Babaji, Madhusudan Das Babaji, they were in Babaji line of Gaudiya Vaishnavism.
So why these Madhusudan Das Babaji, Uddhav Das Babaji, they don't come in our parampara?
They're Babaji, no? In our parampara, most of them are preachers.
But
Jagannatha
Babaji also is not a preacher.
No, but he was a person who preserved philosophy. People who have contributed a lot to our sampradaya, their names are there.
So, he preserved from...
Yeah, he preserved. The Baldevi Division taught to Uddhav Das Babaji, Uddhav Das Babaji, Madhusudan Babaji, or to Jagannatha Das Babaji. Everyone else was confused. So, he learned, he kept with him this knowledge. And he practiced it. And showed. So in our parampara, you will not find these names. After Baldevita Vishnu, you will find whom? Jagannatha Babaji, no? But after Baldevita Vishnu, directly. So what about these Uddhav Das, Madhusudan Das? Their name is not mentioned. Because in our parampara, names of main acharyas are mentioned, who have contributed a lot. Like, for example, after Narottam Das Thakur, you will find Vishwanath Chakri Thakur. Vishwanath Chakri Thakur is not a disciple of Narottam Das Thakur. Narottam Das Thakur's disciple is Ramchandra Chakravarti, and his disciple is Krishna Chandra Chakravarti, and his disciple is Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur.
So Ramachandra
Sangha
Mandi, is that?
No, that is Ramchandra Kaviraj. That is a different. That is a different person.
So Narottam Das Thakur's contemporary was.
No, Ramchandra Kaviraj was a disciple of Srinivas Acharya. And Narottam Das Thakur's friend, Ramchandra Kaviraj. They used to stay in Kumar Hut and Sri Khanda. Still their places are there. You can go and see those places. Very nice place. Well, not exactly preserved, but they are there. So this What I was telling? His Jagannatha Babaji's most of the disciples, whatever disciples were there, they couldn't understand. He's a pure devotee. Somehow. In spite of seeing all these things. And it came to the point that his disciples, Jagannatha Das Babaji's disciples, they went to Bhaktivinoda Thakur to take instruction. They thought he's crack. Jagannatha Das Babaji.
Disciple means they're following for some reason, right, Prabhupada?
Yeah, they thought he'll give us mantra and we'll chant, we'll stay with him, learn something, do some seva, something like that. So they went to Bhaktivinoda Thakur and they told, see, Jagannatha Babaji, what? Jagannatha Babaji asked them to do some service in the garden. And when they asked, okay, you know, you give us something to chant, some mantra, he said, no, you just do gardening of brinjal. He didn't give him mantra. So they were thinking, what's happening? So they went to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they complained. See, Jagannatha Babaji, we went for something, teaching, he didn't give mantra and he's asking us to plant brinjal plants. So Bhaktivedanta Thakur said, he said, you better go back and do whatever he says. Otherwise, you'll go to hell if you contradict his teachings. Then they said, he's not giving any mantra, bhai, we want some mantra to chant. He said, no, whatever he says, you should do. That will be for your benefit. So that's why people could understand, you know, like their instructions are weird, their behavior is different. So they couldn't figure out what's happening. One of his disciples was going to prostitutes. He was like personal servant of Jagannatha Babaji. He was going to prostitutes. They are local prostitutes. So you see the point. They are with Jagannatha Das Babaji, who is Paramahamsa. But they have no idea with whom they are. So that is why it is said, if with Jagannatha Das Babaji you can't take any benefit, then how can you be benefited just by like being together with all of you? It's not, you have to take it. That's all. Just by being together doesn't matter, doesn't have no value, absolutely no value.
Nothing.
You have to take that knowledge and then follow it. Then it benefits, otherwise no benefit. Otherwise, that is why Bhakti Vriksha you can do, it's good, but yeah, that's necessary. But if you don't come together and take knowledge, nothing happens. You just keep on going. When that person is with Jagannatha Babaji and nothing is happening.
Here we have the qualification system.
So that's good. That's what I'm saying, that's good. Because many places this didn't happen, no? They come, have some party, eating and and go back. So that's what I'm saying. It doesn't happen like that. So we have to take things, internalize. So Jagannatha, he's seeing, but even after seeing, he can't understand. That he's there in front of him. Like sometimes we desire, no, maybe if we have association of Prabhupada or Narottam Das Thakur or whatever. If you are not ready, no association can help you. We have to make ourselves ready and clear what we are doing. Otherwise, we'll just be staying. It's like now, okay, fine, in ISKCON, you say, we have taken from Bhakti Charu Maharaj initiation, Javataka Maharaj, Bhakti Vikasa Maharaj, okay, big devotees. But if you want to advance, it will happen, otherwise, nothing will happen. You can have Guru on your altar, picture. Doesn't help. Nothing happens. So you have to take knowledge. That's the only matter. That's what it will help us all of us. So of course we have pictures and that's okay, that's altar. But the idea is to take knowledge, that's the idea. So Jagannatha Das Babaji, he knew his disciple was going to prostitute. That was also funny. He knew this person. But nevertheless, he didn't say anything because He thought anyway, you know, better totally going into Maya. At least he's here and he can probably get okay, you know, after some time. He didn't say much. I don't know why exactly. I don't know what he was thinking, but I can guess probably this is the point. So Jagannatha Das Babaji, Bhakti Sandha Saraswati Thakur, he used to come and have darshan of Jagannatha Das Babaji. But his disciples did not allow him to have his darshan. Because many times he used to come and his disciples used to say, no, he's busy, this, that. Because those disciples were also like crazy, you know. They were envious of him. They were thinking, this Bhakti Santa, he's like becoming big guru and he's coming. But Jagannatha Das Babaji knew actually about real situation of Bhakti Sandha Saraswati Thakur. And some of his stalwart disciples, Bhakti Sandha Saraswati Thakur disciples, they used to come to Jagannatha Das Babaji to have his blessings. He told that, if you go and have blessings of Jagannatha Das Babaji, you will benefit. So they used to go.
He'll spit on the grass and then
Bhakti Sandha Saraswati Thakur. That is, but that is where Vamsi Das Babaji, that's not Jagannatha Das Babaji.
Vamsi?
Vamsi Das Babaji. There's one more Babaji, Vamsi Das Babaji.
Okay.
Yeah, but his actions were weird. Like, Vamsi Das Babaji, he was contemporary of Jagannatha Das Babaji. And he was very weird. Like, he didn't used to eat for 4 days. And after 4 days, he'll take brinjal, kaccha brinjal, eat it. That's all. And then for 4 days, he's not eating. He's walking. And then to his Gaurantha deities, he used to scold them. That if you do some nonsense, I'll beat you with stick. That's, he was in Sakhe Bhav.
His relationship is deep.
Yeah, he's Sakhe Bhav with. That's, he's at platform of love. So, he said, so Babaji's are there, but it's difficult to understand their actions. Because they are, that is why we have Ghoshchanandi, preachers, who come from Uttam Adhikari platform down to Madhyam Adhikari, and then they act in a normal way. So that people could understand them, they can have knowledge from them. Otherwise, they will not understand what's happening and they will not take knowledge. Just like Prabhupada also sometimes, people could understand what he is doing. In Mangal Arati, he is playing with kids. So people are thinking, what's happening? You know, he's playing with kids in Mangal Arati. Mangal Arati is happening, he's playing with kid in the room. And some people lost faith on Prabhupada by seeing all these things. Some people lost faith. Prabhupada was once chanting and he was just playing with a switch, Prabhupada. That's all. Was walking, closing a switch, going back, coming back, opening the switch. Like in corridor, there's a switch. So, Hare Krishna, opening. Hare Krishna, closing. Like he's doing that. And actually, some of his servants got weird, you know, what's happening. So, but Babaji's are like fully weird. Like, you can't understand what they're doing. You'll not be able to understand. That's why Bhakti Santa asked, Bhakti Santa's disciples used to go to Vamsi Das Babaji to have his blessings, but he stopped them. He said, you should not go. Because you'll do some offense. You'll not be able to understand what he's doing. Just stop it. But Jagannatha Das Babaji, he was not exactly so weird like him, because he was also having philosophy, you know, he was carrying that philosophy. So, sometimes Jagannatha Das Babaji continuously chanted for 3 days and three nights in a row without sleeping and without eating. 3 days. But that's anyway less. I told you, he chanted for 1 month without sleeping in Haridwar. 1 month without sleeping, Hare Krishna, full night. That is the absorption of Babaji's service is something else, and Ghoshyanandi's service is something else. Mm-hmm. They have different services. All these Babaji's, their service is to show absorption in holy name. Ghoshyanandi's service, preachers are parampara. Their service is to actually make devotees. So they are two different. So that's why these things, different things are happening. Their service is not to preach. They don't want to preach. it's not their service. So that's Babaji. He was chanting for 3 days and three. He was chanting for 1 month. I told you, continuously. 1 month. Jagannatha Babaji. Oh, Jagannatha Babaji. Also, So this is famous. So in Bengal, there's a place. Vardhman. You know Vardhman, no?
Mm-hmm.
When you go to Calcutta, there's a place Vardhman. You get down. So Vardhman, he walked to Navdeep. That time they were walking. So it took for him 11 days to walk from. Now if you go from Vardhman to Navdeep, if you catch a car, it will take you 5 hours. Okay. So that time if you walk.
They used to walk a lot. Right?
No, but probably Babaji, because he was not walking.
Mm.
He was in the. So probably his disciple was carrying also. So they'll just stop somewhere, then next day they'll go. It took him 11 days. And for 11 days, he was simply chanting. He didn't eat, he didn't do anything, only chanting. Anybody used to come to Jagannatha Babaji and ask for, okay, prasad. He used to chant Hare Krishna. That's a prasad. And then, so people used to ask him, okay, this is some Acharya's appearance day and this, so we'll do some festival. He said, okay, we'll do festival, come, we'll chant whole day. He'll do festival of holy name. He said, just forget all these things. They were Babaji, so they said, forget eating and party and prasad and all these, forget this, this is not festival. They were too much, you know. This is crazy, this is not festival. We'll sit together and chant 3 lakh names. We'll do festival of holy name. That's how they were. Actually, Gaurasvami Babaji, once he actually scolded Bhakti Siddhanta. Like Bhakti Siddhanta was engaging his disciples in deity worship. And then deity worship, of course, it means cooking, prasad, and then festivals, like that. So Gaurasvami Babaji said, Bhakti Siddhanta, what are you doing? This is not Mahaprabhu's movement. He told them. Like there is prasad, there is deity, there is... He said, Mahaprabhu's movement is simply chanting holy names. So Bhakti Siddhanta said to Gaurasvami Babaji, do you think I am wrong? And do you think these people can chant Hare Krishna day and night? They have no ability to do what you are doing. So if you think I am wrong, that's okay. But they cannot do this. So I am trying to help them to come to that level. Slowly and steadily. So then Gaurasvami told, okay, fine, you know. And then he didn't say anything, he stopped. He stopped when Bhakti Siddhanta said that. And probably he knew he was testing Bhakti Siddhanta. He became happy and then Bhakti Siddhanta went. So ideally, our aim is, ideally we should, the amount of absorption we have in preaching, the same amount of absorption we should have in holy name. If we can preach 24 hours, we should be able to also chant 24 hours. Because in old age, we'll be doing that, no? You can't preach. What will you do? You'll be just lying on the bed and Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. So you should be practiced for that. And so these Babajis were like that. Day and night they were chanting. So he chanted for 11 days, day and night, without eating. Simply. And Jagannatha Babaji, by the way, he used to chant loudly. I just told you. He used to chant so loud that people can hear, you know. Like if you are staying in the room, next room, you can hear his voice. That loud he used to chant. Hare Krishna, 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 like that. So if you're chanting whole day and night, you become tired also, no? Like they were doing that. So, Prapanna Ashram was there. In Amalatocho, yeah. So in this is all. Okay, it is said that I've told you everything. Babaji Maharaj. Okay, Bhaktivedanta Swami Thakur was well versed in astronomy. You know that, no? He was so well versed in astronomy and mathematics that he was called to become HOD of BHU, Banaras Hindu University. He was actually summoned that you become HOD. He denied it. He told, I have nothing to do with all this stuff. You know, I have come here to propagate the movement of Lord Chaitanya. Just denied. But Jagannatha Babaji, he heard that Bimal Prasad, Bhaktivedanta Thakur, he is very scholarly in astronomy. So he called him and he asked him to make a calendar, Vaishnav calendar. Well, at that time, community was not having Vaishnav calendar. So what Vaishnav calendar we have, this was initiated by Jagannatha Das Babaji. Nirtam Das Thakur's appearance, Ramchand Kaviraj, and all these Shriyacharya appearance. So he did that. And so Bhaktivedanta Thakur made calculations and began publishing Srinavdi Panchika. At that time, so you know this calendar is called as Panchika. You know?
Panchakam.
Yeah.
In Tamil it is called Panchakam.
Panchangam. Yeah, so it is, yeah. Yeah, Pancha, yeah, Panchangam. Or in Bengali it is called Panchika. So he made actually Navdi Panchika. So this version of calendar is made by Bhakti Siddhanta on the order of Jagannatha Das Babaji. What you have now.
Jagannatha
Das Babaji found out the Mayapur
birthplace, he was
already 120
years old, right?
Hmm.
So
Bhaktisiddhanta
was born at that time?
Yeah, Bhaktisiddhanta was born. He was like 11, 12 years old or something like that. He was young, no? When Mayapur's place was found?
Hmm.
No, that time he was old enough. He was like 19, 20 years.
Bhaktisiddhanta.
He passed his school and college, university. That is why when Bhaktivedanta Thakur started this, building this yoga peet, building this temple, he handed over the management to Bhaktisiddhanta. He said, you should manage now.
Okay.
Because I am old, you know, so I can't manage. So he put him on management. So he was like 29, 20. He was young enough. So, Jagannatha Das Babaji's disciple was Bhagwat Das Babaji, whose samadhi is still there in Ambika Kalna. Ambika Kalna is a place near Mayapur. And there he is famous as Bhagwat Das Babaji. If you go in Ambika Kalna, ask anybody where is Bhagwat Das Babaji's Badi. They say Badi. Badi means house. Bhagwat Das Babaji's body, they will say, okay, we went there. And so he was such a great devotee that he was chanting and he wanted to go to Ganges. So Ganges from there is like, it is like if you walk from his place, Ganges is probably, so 1 kilometer. But he became old and nothing, so he started chanting and he thought Ganges, how will I go and take bath and worship her? So Ganges appeared there, and still you have their well where Ganges appeared for him. So Jagannatha Das Babaji's disciple was Bhagwat Das Babaji. Bhagwat Das Babaji's disciple was Gaur Kishore Das Babaji. So you got the point? Now Gaur Kishore Babaji is not a disciple of Bhaktivedanta Thakur. He is not a disciple of Bhaktivedanta Thakur. Gaur Kishore Babaji is a disciple of Bhagwat Das Babaji. Who is a disciple of Jagannatha Das Babaji? But Gaur Kishore Babaji, he accepted Bhaktivedanta Thakur as a senior. Because Bhaktivedanta Thakur is disciple, he took Shiksha so he took Shiksha from Jagannatha Das Babaji. So Jagannatha Babaji is Gaur Kishore Babaji, Jagannatha Babaji is disciple's disciple. So Bhaktivedanta Thakur automatically becomes senior now. And in fact, Gaur Kishore Babaji, he used to also come to Bhaktivedanta Thakur to ask questions and associate. So that's when Godhroom, you see his house and also Gaur Kishore Das Babaji's place. He built a place for him that whenever he comes, he can stay and they can do kirtans and they can associate.
Mm-hmm. One question about that Bipin Bihari Goswami.
Bipin Bihari Goswami, he was guru of Bhaktivedanta Thakur. But then later some confusion happened. And Bhaktivedanta Thakur didn't really take instructions from Bipin Bihari. He took instructions from Jagannatha Das Babaji. It's happened like that.
And so I think Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati made this Guru Parampara, right?
He made this Guru Parampara. He wrote this, how it goes, like that. So this is this is good. Actually, this past time. So once when Babaji was traveling, a wealthy man gave him a rupee. A wealthy man gave him 1 rupee. 1 rupee at that time.
Yes.
Big thing. A wealthy man with 1 rupee. Now if you say wealthy man with 1 rupee. So he gave him 1 rupee. And that 1 rupee, so Babaji took him. And Babaji took that 1 rupee and gave it to his servant, who used to carry him in the basket. His servant's name was Bihari. So he gave. So after journeying for some miles, like they walked miles, and his servant was carrying him in the basket on the head. So he had 1 rupee. Some miles, he said, "You should take me back to the donor." And he took him back and he returned his 1 rupee. You see how it goes. So you can't predict what happens. This Babaji is, you know, or that he just returned back. And so he told that man, Jagannatha Babaji told that man, "I understand that you have a good deal of money, but I could not bear the burden of 1 rupee. And I wonder how you can tolerate the burden of so many rupees." He told that. That is Babaji's fully renounced, like Goswami's Kantha Kopina Shritau. They have nothing and they don't want to keep nothing. That's how the system is. So of course Babaji Maharaj sometimes accepted donations, but whenever he accepted donations, the next moment he would buy something for Vaishnavas and distribute it, finish that money. He never used to keep money with him, because he said money is snake and it can poison your mind at any time. That's what most of these Vaishnavacharyas, they were very careful of money. Na dhanam, na janam, na sundare. Money, land, woman. They were very careful of this. We were talking about Sri Sampradaya. So there is a acharya in Sri Sampradaya. Who was that? Whose house is also there? Oh yeah, Vedanteshika. You know Vedanteshika, no? Yes. Come on.
He's from Vadakalai.
Okay. So Vedanteshika, he's a big acharya, you know, Vadakalai Sampradaya. So his wife was there and he of course, he used to beg, traditional system, beg and take. So they were poor, of course. So one of his disciples gave him a bag of rice to keep. Okay, this is a guru also. Gave you keep for offering Krishna and taking your food. They took. But in that bag, he kept gold rings and gold necklace. For his guru, because he was seeing, you know, like they're begging, and so he hid it so that when they will eat, they will find, and then they can sell and they can do. So he kept. So Vedanteshika, anyway, he was not interested. So his wife was cooking. So she found once his gold rings and necklace and woman, like nice ornaments. So she took and she put it on her this, and she put necklace. So Vedanteshika came, he said, "What is this?" So, but they were so poor that she never saw gold rings. She never saw those gold necklaces, except on God. So Vedanta Sikha told, you know, so you know what is this? What the America, you know, it's, how can they do this?
Once in a week, they come for mowing the grass, bro. That
happened to me
today.
Oh. Yeah. They're. Acha.
Maintain the lawn and trees.
Oh, I can understand. So they can use that catchy, you know, with no noise. Big. So anyway, so Vedanta Shikha has told his wife, so you know what are these rings and this? He told these are snakes. First they will go around your finger, then around your neck, and then around your heart, and then poison you. So he took everything off, and then went back to that person, a disciple, and he gave everything. You take it. We don't want. So this is about Sri Sampradaya. And in Madhva Sampradaya, we have great Acharya and Guru, Vyasatirtha. You know Vyasatirtha? Sampradaya, there's a name, Vyasatirtha. So he went somewhere, he used to go and preach. So some king gave him so much gold, as he was very happy with his scholarliness, knowledge, him gold, okay, you take gold. So Vyasatirtha, he told, okay, he took, and he went. So there was a river nearby. He went and he dumped all the gold in the river. Just everything. So that king told, what happened? You're a crazy man. So Vyasatirtha told, this is not gold, this is death. You gave me death. And I've offered this death to the river. So king was very impressed by his renunciation. So that's the idea. That's, we can have money, but we should keep so much money only which is useful for preaching. Or maybe your, as a congregation, your life goes on preaching. But any extra money should be immediately put in service of Lord. Otherwise, we'll create friction, fights. Money is like that, no? Money is a thing which can make a disciple kill his guru. That's money. So many times I've seen Udupi, I was there. I've seen there so many times, like this Chota Guruji, there's like Chota Swami and Big Swami, generally in Matano. Or that Chota Swami, what they call, I don't know.
Yeah.
In Srivasa we call Chinna.
Chinna.
There's Chinna Jihar. But in Madhva also it's like that. We don't call Chinna, there's some other time, Kannada. Chota Swami, Bada Swami. And so this, I've seen many times that Bada Swamiji, he's out, and from behind him he just takes all the property and everything in his name and finish, and when he comes, he's out of the game. It happens there also. Madhva Sampradaya, you can imagine. GSPs are there. So money can be intoxicating. So we have to be careful. But these Babajis, they don't want anything, first of all. So this Babaji, he did like that. And he, by this instance, he showed detachment and showing how much he should be attentive in accepting charity. Because in charity, whatever money will come, it will also bring reactions with it. And if you don't utilize everything for Krishna, then you start getting involved in that. There was one, it is said in Vrindavan, it's a famous story, that one prostitute was there and Krishna appeared to him. She started doing devotion. And Krishna told, she then told Krishna, what should I do? I want to become pure. So Krishna told, okay, distribute all your property. And use your money, feed all Vaishnavas. And just renounce and chant. She did. Then all of these Babajis, they came and ate and attended program. So in the night, all of them, their minds were so disturbed. What's happening? We can't remember Krishna. It's all gone. So next morning everybody came and they told, it happened with everybody. Well, what happened? So they told, you know, like, we went to that party. Attending a party, eating the food, this happened. So it was sinful money. And we were involved. So they went to prostitute. They told, see, you messed up, you know, like, we couldn't do bhajan. And we whole night, we couldn't chant. So that was, she told, she was so unhappy. So she prayed to Krishna, Krishna please, why this happened? So Krishna came, Krishna told, I told you to distribute, you did that. That's okay, it's not your fault. But it's their fault. I told them that you, whenever you accept things, don't accept more than necessary, don't enjoy it. And any extra thing, distribute. But when they all came, they accepted and they ate and everything, enjoyed. Oh, but they enjoyed everything. They did that. So Krishna knows, and they were like messed up. So these, it's not your problem. So the point is, when you accept something, if we have enjoying propensity, we start getting implicated with that money. Because we don't know from where it's coming, no? Like you are earning, but you also don't know from where it's coming. It's all system is very, very, yeah. So Gaurav Babaji, huh? Yeah, it's like all corrupted. So that is what is Jagannatha Das Babaji.